the original hall here was built for the community from the First World War, so this goes back, you know, quite a long time. Some time ago, it was the council decided to close it to save some money. There was a big meeting held here, and there was about 100 people downstairs in the hall downstairs, and they were really wanted to keep it open. There was a lot of feeling from the community. A lot of people had used this in the youth as a youth centre. There was a lot of feeling from the community that they wanted to keep it open. A lot of the groups that were here, because it was under threat of closure, up and left, and the remaining ones were trying to find somewhere else to go. The local councillors were very proactive in trying to keep it open, and at the same time Invest Local came on board with some funding, and we decided that we would try and give it a go to keep the community centre open. Initially we leased it on a 6-month lease to see how we went. We felt fairly confident with the backing of Invest Local that we could actually make a contribution to the community to keep it open. Since then, Peter, who's another trustee, has been very proactive in getting groups on board, and now it's quite a thriving community.
I think the answer's in the name, really. It's a hub. You know, the hub of Hubberston, really. This has always been traditionally a very important building, from the Memorial Hall days to the days when there was a thriving youth club. Then it went into an area where it was not used at all, and it'll be a year now since we've taken it over as trustees. And it is more of a well-being centre. It's not a community centre. Everything we do there has some kind of well-being issue with, whether it's preschool children with parents interacting, whether it's elderly people or middle-aged people who might have retired early, playing table tennis, short mat bowls, it's sort of line dancing. And what we try to be as inclusive as possible to make sure that people do feel comfortable in the environment here. You'll find that a lot of people will find it much more comfortable coming here for a fitness class than they would going to their local leisure centre. So really, it's a well-being hub, really, that captures a large population base of around 5,000 people, really, between Hakin and Hubberston. Our little Acorns playgroup is thriving. You know, we've got 56 children coming here every week. We've got the Flying Starter based here now as well, which is great for those families who need that little bit of extra help. And I just wonder what could have happened to those children and the strains of young sort of families, etc., had we not been a sort of outlet for those.
If the community centre had closed, it's extremely likely that our group would have closed because we were unable to find suitable accommodation to meet our needs anywhere else. We have upwards currently of 50 children on the register across the week, so we get very good feedback. We've always had parents telling us that it's means a lot to them, that they're an early start for their children to come and have fun, to learn those pre-steps before they go into school. Parents get to meet each other that might not have met before. It does provide a hub for the community, and within the centre we know there are playgroup parents and families that are using the centre in other ways.
It gives a lot of people like me on their own somewhere to go and socialise and keep in touch with everybody. Yeah.
And have you met some new people?
Yes, yeah. And some old ones I haven't seen for ages.
The next phase is engaging with our 11 to 14 year olds, so try and get them engaged so that they have some ownership over the building. You know, we've got free wireless, etc. There's a coffee bar. So hopefully in September, by working with Milford Youth Matters, we can engage with those.
And we're still trying to sort of get more groups on board, but we feel quite confident that we're nearly there with it being self-sufficient.